escape another cop. If I am a police in a public place, a writ of warrant of lies, asking the authorities, what are the circumstances? Where do you derive the powers? Whether the power is properly exercised? Whether magistrate gave an order before the barrier was opened? I give a raw illustration for the youngsters to carry. From where did you receive the powers? What were the circumstances compelling you to open a fire on the public? Let me explain you. That is the power of warrant of the court exercises. If the authority proceeds with a matter without having jurisdiction, of course, a warrant is to be issued. But a prohibited order can be passed, asking the authority not to proceed with that. The writ of prohibition. If the authority, without jurisdiction or in exercise of improper powers, passes the final order, stage of quarantine has gone, stage of prohibition has gone, a certiorari can be issued. The question doesn't stay there. An authority having powers fails to exercise the powers or exercise the powers in a wrong manner, in an arbitrary manner, then a writ of mandamus is issued to act in a particular manner. Let me tell you, I've been asked to say, who can file the writ? Quarantine, anybody? Anybody. I am using the word anybody, not the citizen. Anybody. The scope is very wide for a warrant. There was a lot of trouble in Cuttack City. Fire, arson, fire brigade. Fire brigades were pulled down on the streets of Cuttack. The opposition wanted to raise the voice. I advised the man who later became the chief minister that we can file a writ of quarantine. Immediately my mouth was put to shut by so-called senior friends. Apparently I tell they had no knowledge about quarantine. About 2 months thereafter, a senior advocate's son's marriage, the man who later became chief minister, he was there. The senior advocate heard my discussions with the gentleman, leader of the opposition. Then he immediately said, Manu, why don't you file a writ of quarantine? The intelligent, the political man was an intelligent man. He recalled what month back he was telling about writ of quarantine. Others shot him down. Senior is telling, experienced lawyer is telling that quarantine. Then while leaving that place, he requested me, sir, please draft a writ of quarantine. I said, it's already drafted. But there were political compulsions. That writ was not filed. And there was a change of government, and that gentleman became chief minister, and he asked for implication of that judicial inquiry. You see, judicial inquiry on a particular issue and asking for a quarantine are two different things. In a quarantine, a court can put its long hand to get anything and everything. In a judicial inquiry, I think affidavits only are called. Government public officers do not divulge the truth 100%. Therefore, in a riot case of Delhi, people say that judicial inquiry report was not correct or tainted. But friends, that People did not come to file affidavits. Judge himself had to go street and collect information and put it there. There are political pressure on him that don't write that report. He didn't hear. He wrote that up. And when asked, he said, prerogative is with you. You make decision and that's the parliament or may not. They immediately came to pass an order that judicial inquiry report is a highly discretionary. We may place, we may not place. They did not place long after it is placed. And now the CBI police, depending upon that report, highly prosecutions. So question is a judicial inquiry into a matter and a quarant or writ, two different things. In a quarant or writ, rights can be exercised in a right, honest manner. And every day we are obtaining prohibited writ petitions at the admission stage, the stay order, the injunction. These are all writ of prohibition issued at the threshold. Who can do it? A petitioner of a writ petition can always ask for the prohibition order for a writ of prohibition as initio. Security, I have explained. But why I'm telling you, I'm telling you three cases. My experience, my time, not the remote asking for this reported or not reported. In the case of Keli Kadamba High School, not reported in any other, but in High Court, IL, 1979-80, you can mending committee of Keli Kadamba High School, where the court said existence of the right is sine qua non for maintaining a writ application. What happened? A band of citizens who are in management of a particular school, they were dethroned by order of the DPI. They came in a writ petition. It was found that those persons who were appointed or nominated for 3 years, the 3 years had left. So by lapse of time, their right was not available with them, and therefore the writ petition at their instance was not maintainable. It's a reported in IL. In the case of Basanti Mahanti, an unaided educational institution managed by a society, unaided school, unaided college, managed by a society. It was registered for admission or mental illness question raised. Because there before, in the case of Elias Smith, this court held a school managed by the mission, no read lights. In this case, also same stand was being taken. No ADC, therefore no read lights. Justice B.L. Hansari, it's a reported case, Basanti Mahanti versus Darrington. Justice Hansari had took the view that his school is discharging a public duty. The school, although not getting funds from the government, but had to impart education in terms of the statutory provisions of the country. And therefore, if there is a violation of Article 14, he replies, and he dragged the point of natural justice to say, natural justice within the fold of Article 14, and therefore replies, and in that case, writ was allowed. The door was made wide open by judicial pronouncements from time to time, and really, door was closed. There is a door, there is an opening. We, by our conduct, our poor understanding, we close the door. He made it open. In another case, judges transfer case, a lawyer filed a case. It was held maintainable He is the best man to raise the question in PIL case, first PIL case, then this transfer case. Same analogy. At Sundargarh Art College, university was thinking of closing it down. Some of the university was thinking of closing it down. Students came and identified, sir, you were registered. What these students have got to say? Our college, we have been closed down. Just the Sansarian's case. No, students are vitally interested in the college. Who else will be interested in the college? Mentally. So then, let me close it here and tell you something more. It depends upon the judge, his appreciation, his understanding, his human factors. 100 years back, a case was filed in the American Supreme Court that in schools, colored people are asked to sit in a separate class. It is discrimination. We then judges 100 years back said, no, best of the teachers are teaching you. All the amenities are available merely because you are sitting in a separate classroom. There is no discrimination. 100 years after. Same Supreme Court of United States said that that is discrimination. Asking a colored boy to sit in a separate classroom. The question is appreciation 100 years. It took 100 years to understand that point. Rotary clubs, you know, ladies were not allowed to be members of Rotary Club. They had to fight case and ultimately activists said, you can't make a discrimination to the ladies in a society. They can only be member or cannot be member. Unless very scientific reasons are given, very cogent reasons are given, real persons are maintainable. But friends, 25 years practice, 10 years in your adjudicating authority, another 10 years by now. If you ask me whether REIT is the best way or a suit, I will say go to the suit. There, by virtue of your acumen, by virtue of the evidences, you can convert the munsaf or the subjects and get the judgment. Here, begging Baba. Thank you, sir.